And if I never make it, then at least I live to go try. At least I live to go try.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Luis Revelo Jr. back at you with another video, and we are here. It is Tuesday morning, 4:16 a.m. We're gonna get this pool workout, try to knock it out within 45 minutes or so. I'm really trying to get my workouts done within an hour. They've usually been taking about an hour and a half, but I gotta cut it down to an hour, so I'm gonna kind of superset a lot of stuff because I want to start training some clients early in the a.m. to knock it out, because I need to knock out at least 4 sessions a day. That's my goal that I set for myself. So I want to do 2 in the morning and then 2 in the evening. Do one at 5 a.m., one at 6 a.m. and then one at 6 p.m. and one at 7 p.m. In order to do that, I gotta knock my workout out within an hour from 4 to 5. So let's get started.
Traffic in the white, please Lord, don't let me go to jail tonight. Yeah. Who me? I'm a soul survivor. Ask about him in the street, the boy G's a rider. 100 grand on my wrist, yeah, life sucks. The club dog, I'd rather count $1 million.
Hey. If you're looking for me, I'll be on the block with my thing cock, possibly sitting on a trap now. Because I'm a rider.
I know getting in the gym can be difficult. You gotta stop looking at things like you have to do them and start looking at things like you get to do them, because life is a blessing no matter what. Even your sufferings are a blessing. You may not see it now in the moment, but trust me, whatever it is that you're going through is truly meant to make you stronger. It's building you for a specific task at some point in life. Everything that I've ever gone through has been used as an opportunity to help someone at a later date. Everything that I experienced, I was able to then help someone in the future going through a similar situation. Whatever you're going through, trust me, know that there is something good that's going to come of it. You just have to have faith and continue to trust God. Because I know the mistake we make is we start to blame God. But a lot of times we're blaming Him for things that are our fault. Extreme gratitude. You gotta have fun, guys. You gotta have fun in the gym. Otherwise, it can get very monotonous and repetitive. When you do what you love, you don't call it work. Writing down what I just did in my app, which is the same app that you'll be using if you train with me. 75, then we did 60, 50, 40. I think I did an extra one. No worries. I'm gonna go light on these because I'm gonna superset right now. So we're just gonna do 20s because I gotta do 25 and then hammer curls. 6, 7. You'll be surprised. People are always so focused on how heavy weight you're lifting. Listen, you can get a solid workout with some light weights if you do it correctly. With the proper intensity and rest time.
3, 3, 4, 3, 5.
And also remember, guys, you have to train specific to what your goals are. My goal right now is to shred down. Not necessarily to build muscle or compete in bodybuilding or this or that. I'm just trying to get shredded, get lean, and get my weight down. I'm a boxer, not a bodybuilder. I'm an athlete, but I still want to look good. I will focus on building muscle later. But right now, I gotta try to strip down all the fat. I'm starting to feel it already. 1, 2, 3, 25.
When I was a juvenile, stuck to the G code. This ain't a rap song, this is my life. If the world was a battlefield, then I earned stripes.
If you're looking for me, I'll be on the clock for my thing cock, possibly sitting on a trap now.
Listen, it's not about killing yourself in the gym every single time you go in there. It's just about staying consistent, getting the blood flowing, raising that frequency up, getting in the zone, just getting your mind right. I don't need to go bench 3 plates to feel good. Like, I'm good with a plate, do 20, 25 reps, you know, 5 sets of that, or mixing it up, you know, supersetting, doing this, breaking the sweat, and I'm feeling the pump and I'm getting in the zone. That's all you need to put yourself in a positive mental attitude. You gotta earn that positive mental attitude. Whether it's this, whether it's walking, whether it's going for a light jog in the morning, doing some burpees, some push-ups, whatever it is, doesn't matter. As long as you're getting the blood flow and the oxygen up, it's gonna benefit you. You're gonna feel good afterwards, trust me. Without this, I can't function the rest of my day. Whenever I don't work out, or in the past, because I haven't missed yet in 2023, but whenever I don't wake up and get a good workout, my day is just all over the place. Like, things just don't seem to work the way they're supposed to work for whatever reason. So you gotta make it a staple. It's gotta be part of the routine. And the people that hit me up for coaching, who want the business coaching and stuff like that, but don't want the fitness part, it's like, bro, they go hand in hand. The reason that you're struggling in business is most likely 99% chance is because you're not doing what you need to do on the health aspect of your life. That's what happens to most entrepreneurs. We forget about ourselves and we're so focused on making money, providing, taking care of people that we don't take care of ourselves. And I've learned, yes, I am selfish in a sense because I have to be here for me, because I have to take care of me before I can take care of anybody else. Without me doing this, I can't be a good husband, I can't be a good father, I can't be a good leader, a businessman, because this is what gets me in the zone. This is what gets my mind right. This is what sets the tone for my day. This is how I win the day. Every single day that I come in here and I let go and I forget and I take out my frustrations of everything, it's in here. You think I enjoy my son waking up every hour and a half, 2 hours, crying in the middle of the night when I have to get up at 3 a.m. to do what I gotta do to make sure that I'm the best me that I can be for him? It's like, I'm getting up early so I can be a better father for you, to give you a better life, my boy, and you're keeping daddy awake, you know what I'm saying? But it's okay, he's a baby, I love him to death, you know? It's just another test for me. But still, it's not easy. And you get frustrated sometimes when they're crying and you don't know what to do and you don't know like how to make them stop. But it's like, that's part of growing. That's part of being a parent. That's part of learning and understanding like how to be patient, just like God is patient with us. And that's something that having a child has really opened my eyes to, is if I can love my son this much, imagine how much God loves you and loves me. That's perspective. Listen guys, today's morning devotional was about work. Being grateful for having work to do. I feel like many of us go through life not appreciating our positions in life, our jobs, where we go to work, the opportunity that we have to work. I come from an immigrant family. My parents are from Mexico. My mom lives in Mexico right now. My mom makes $80 a week, all right? To put that into perspective. Working 10 hours a day as a waitress, as a server, she makes $80 a week. Some of you are complaining about making $80 a day, and nobody even makes $80 a day anymore. That's $10 an hour for like an 8-hour day. You guys live such a privileged life. You complain about nothing. You spend your days like, oh, I'm depressed, I'm anxious. Listen, back in the days, depression and anxiety didn't exist. You know why? Because people had responsibilities. People had things to do, people to take care of. You don't have time to be depressed and anxious when you're worried about taking care of your family, when you're worried about taking care of your loved ones. Never in my life did I ever hear a man say that he suffered from anxiety or depression when I was a kid. Growing up, I never heard that ever in my life. I didn't start hearing that until I was in my mid-20s recently. Why? Because of social media, because of the world, society. They're pushing all of this depression and anxiety. They want you guys to be depressed. They want you to be anxious. Why do you think alcohol and weed is legal? Because it helps you stay in that mind state. It helps you stay in that frame. And I don't care, some of you may say, oh, you know, weed isn't that bad, or a drink here and there isn't that bad. Sure, bro, look at it however you want. You're the same person that says I can quit whenever I want, but you haven't quit in 10 years. You've never taken a break. So I don't want to hear it, bro, because I know the truth. I've been there. I've done it. I started smoking when I was 12 years old. I smoked my first cigarette when I was 4. And guess who gave it to me? One of my uncles. Guess who gave me my first beer? One of my uncles. Why? Because that's just the culture, you know? It was funny to them. I still remember the day. I was at a little family party near Boyle Heights. One of my dad's uncles. It was a family party. They were just sitting around. They were having a couple beers, you know, like most Mexican families do. And my uncle smoked and they just kind of like, obviously I was a kid. I was curious. I was wondering what it was. And they let me take a hit of it. And obviously I didn't like it. And they laughed at the face that I made when I smoked it. Same thing with the beer. They let me try a little bit of beer, and obviously I made a face, and that face was funny to them. I get where they're coming from, but at the same time, it's like, why do we do that as a culture? Why do we do that as people, especially Mexicans? Drinking is such a heavy part of our culture. Like, every song makes you want to get drunk. Every song makes you want to go, saca la botella, compa. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just makes you want to drink, and you think you're going to have a good time, but really, what are you drinking for? Why are you so sad? What's making you want to drink that bad? For me, why I wanted to drink is because I missed my wife. She wasn't my wife at the time. We were separated from each other, but the only reason why I would hear those Vicente songs or those Los Rieleros songs or like any like Mexican corridos or Ariel Camacho songs, like the only reason I wanted to drink was because I had pain inside. I had a pain of a lost love. I missed my wife. I missed the love of my life. That's the reason why I wanted to drink, because I just didn't want to deal with the fact that she wasn't here. I didn't want to deal with the fact that she had left me. I didn't want to deal with the fact that I messed it up, that I pushed her away, that I made her feel like she wasn't worth it to me, you know, worth my time. In reality, if it wasn't for that, I wouldn't drink. I never started drinking until we broke up. I never used to drink. Even though I had my first beer at 4 and my first cigarette at 4 and my first, you know, blunt at 12, I had never gotten addicted to it. I had never done it afterwards. I tried it once and then I never really touched it again. I did it periodically. Like, I didn't touch a cigarette until I was like 14, 15 again, because I was around people who used to smoke a lot and I wanted to be cool and I wanted to try it out and act like I knew what's up and all this and that. But at the end of the day, like, nothing good comes of it. All you do is waste money, waste time, and then end up doing something you regret, or it ends up killing you in the long run. So why do we do that to ourselves? Why do we do that to our people, to our culture? You know, as fathers, why do you set that example for your son? A father that drinks, a father that likes to get drunk. The messed up part is that in our culture, like, that's okay. In our culture, we think that that's cool. Like, that makes you a man. Downing botellas de mezcal and all this stuff makes you a man. Smoking cigarettes and being tough and rugged, like, that makes you a man. That's not a man, bro. A man has responsibilities. A man sets a good example for his family. A man respects his wife. A man shows his son that he loves his wife by being loyal to her, by being there for him, by being there for his family, not being a mujeriego, like, out in the street, getting drunk, flirting with women at the bar when you have a wife and kids at home. Bro, what are you doing? What are you doing? Why do we teach that? Why do we make that okay? Don't get me wrong, like, there's a standard, because people who don't know me might say that I'm a machista, that because in my relationship, I'm the man, I lead the way. It's my household, so it's my responsibility to do what I gotta do to take care of my family. But a lot of you feminists out there will be like, oh, you're controlling, you're insecure, this and that. Nah, dude, first of all, you're single and you're unhappy. And most of the guys that you date, you probably don't even actually like. You just date them because you use them as a way to distract yourself, to entertain yourself for the night. But you're not really into that person. So I don't need advice from you. I don't need advice from any single people. I don't need advice from you feminists to feel some type of way about men. Like, what is that? Like, I don't feel no type of way towards women. I don't sit here and say, oh, all women are bad. Like, women are this, this, and that. All these, like, podcasts, like, Fresh and Fit, and where they said women this and, like, high value man. Like, bro, that's a bunch of, like, oh my goodness. If you watch that stuff and you're into that, like, you just make me cringe, bro, as a man. Like, if you like that kind of stuff, just shows me, like, you still got a lot of growing to do, my boy, because that's not what a man does. That's not what a real man does. A real man doesn't sit and watch podcasts about dating for an hour or two a day, or watch constant Andrew Tate videos, like, learning how to get women and stuff like that. Like, that's what an insecure little boy does. And I'm telling you because that was me. I used to do that. I used to be in that position. But now I look back at it and I'm just thinking how stupid it is. Like, why did I waste my time trying to do that? But actually, I'll tell you why. Because I was hurt. I was hurt inside because I had lost my girl and I missed my girl, and I wanted to blame her and blame the situation for the way things happened, and I didn't want to take responsibility for it. But at the end of the day, if you're hurting because of a relationship, it's more than likely your fault for acting a certain way. We just got to do better, man. We got to do better. That's why I'm here. I'm here to teach you guys the right way to live, not just because of what I think or what I think is right, because of what the Bible says and what God says is right. And to a lot of people in the world, the Bible is machista. The Bible is misogynist. That's what people say, right? But listen, the only people that I know that are in, like, genuine loving relationships are Christian and are people who follow the Bible. You may look at people on Instagram who aren't saved and who look like they have it all together, but behind closed doors, I know those people don't have the best relationships, because I've seen it in person. I've seen people who on the ground they look perfect, and in real life they have a horrible relationship. They don't talk to each other. When they have dinner together, both of them are on their phone the whole time. They don't actually spend time with each other. And the people that I know at church who have been together for 10 plus years, yes, they struggle in their relationships, but they love each other, and you can see it. You can see it in the way the wife treats the husband. You can see it in the way the husband treats the wife. Like, it's very evident that they love each other. But anyways, I say all that to say this. I went off on a tangent, but the work instills the worth in anything in life, relationships and your careers and family. It all takes work. It takes work to have a good relationship. It takes work to be successful in life. It takes work to get close to God and be disciplined and read your Bible and pray and have a good relationship with God. Imagine, you know what's so sad? Sorry, I'm gonna rant again, but you know what's sad is that we think that 5 minutes with God is enough. We think that, like, oh, we're doing something because we did our little 5 minute devotional. But it's like, dude, if I only spent 5 minutes with my wife, you think she would be with me for a long time? If I said, all right, babe, I did my 5 minutes with you, I'm not gonna see you for the rest of the day. Like, what? How sad is that that is our standard now as Christians, like that 5 minutes a day in our Bible, 5 minutes a day with God, one day a week at church, think you're doing something. We gotta set the standard higher, bro. We gotta strive for more, for better, because that is just not cutting it. That is not enough. Think about it. 5 minutes, guys? Is that what the creator of this universe is worth to you? Only 5 minutes of your day? I'm here to set the example. I'm here to set the standard. I'm here to help my people, la raza, the people that don't know any better, you know? Why do Hispanic and Mexican cultures like always struggle financially? It's because we're not taught financial literacy. We're not taught how to invest. We're not taught how to save. But guess what everybody says about us, especially Mexicans? What do they say? Man, those Mexicans can work hard. Those Mexicans are hard workers, but I never met a harder worker than a Mexican, you know, stuff like that. We're taught to work hard, but we're not taught how to make our money work hard for us. And that's what I'm trying to change in the world, not just how we handle our relationships, but how we handle our finances, because I want you guys to do better. I want my people to do better. I want my people to strive and not just settle for mediocrity. You guys deserve better. You deserve more. And I'm here to remind you that you deserve more. I'm here to tell you that you deserve more. I'm not just talking about material things. I'm talking in life, in relationships, in everything. You can do better. So stop settling for less. That's why I'm here, is to be the light, be the change that I want to see in the world. And I want to see my people succeed. With that being said, guys, I hope you guys are enjoying these videos. I hope you guys enjoy the content. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share it with somebody who needs the inspiration, guys, and be a part of the community. Follow me on Instagram. Come shoot me a DM. Let's talk. Let's network. You need mentoring? Hit me up for coaching. Nothing in life worth having comes easy, but if we all do our part, we can change. We can change the future. We can change our culture. We truly can change the world, but first, it starts with you. You have to believe that it's possible. Otherwise, it will never happen. So, with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next one.